Morning everyone, it's Mish here, and today I'm going to be starting another playlist, which is a card a day until Christmas. The first card that we're going to do is one of my favorite all-time folds. It's just the book fold card, which looks like this. And well, what you're going to need for this is you're going to need a piece of cardstock. Which would be, I think it's 8.5. No, it's 11 by 4.25. So you're going to take an 8.5 by 11, and you're just basically going to cut it in half. We're going to score in the middle. So the score would be at 5.5. Let's just double check there, which be at 5.5. And you can do that on a scoreboard. You can get your scoreboard out and take your phone folder and go to 5.5 and make a line there. Or if you don't have a scoreboard, just fold it in half. All right. And then you're also going to make a score at 6.75. So there's 6, 1, 2, 3/4 there. I got a glare off my my light there. But there's 6.25, 1/2, and 3/4. So you're just going to score there. Again, if you don't have a scoreboard, then you can just approximate and fold. Your fold would be about 1 1/4 from your center fold. Okay, so it's kind of hard to see, but then you're going to get a shape like that. You want to fold it back on itself and just score that well so that it this part's going to lay flat and this is going to hinge open. All right, so that's the only fold that we need to make for that. Just put that away. Here somewhere. And then you're going to need a mat layer. Okay, so your mat is just a plain piece that we're going to put on it like so. And this piece measures four square. Okay, so 4 by 4. And then we're going to get some kind of a patterned piece. A single-sided is fine. And your pattern piece is going to be just slightly smaller at 3 3/4 square. Okay, so then we're just going to adhere that. I'm just using a Elmer's tape runner, but you can use whatever you like. And we'll just try and get an equal border around your four sides. Okay. And then that can go down onto your card base. I love these. I knew that was going to go out. That's why I have a backup here. I have all kinds of little runners that are almost, I think that's probably just run out. So we're going to adhere this. If your piece of patterned paper is directional, you want to make sure you get it down in the right direction. So by that I mean, you don't want to put, well, unless you want to, it upside down or sideways. So just kind of think about how you want that to look on the card. The other thing I sometimes do is before I adhere it, I turn it upside down to just kind of eyeball how much of a border I'm going to have. And then when I put it down, then I have a better idea of what my border spaces are going to be like. Okay. So get that down, and then you need a little side panel, okay, which is going to go here. So you're going to have a mat there, which is roughly 1 inch by 4 inches. Okay, so it will, when we get it on there, we want to line it up with, as best we can, with the layer that's already on there. All right, and then for your layer, This is roughly 3/4 by 3 3/4. Okay, so 3/4 by 3 3/4. So we're just gonna, again, get that down. You can use glue for this. The only thing about PVA glue, like Elmer's glue or glitter glue, is that too much of the glue can cause your paper to warp. So you do want to go sparingly. Another good glue to use is your Tombow. That works really well. But for paper products, in general, a silicone base won't make your paper warp. So that's your Fabri-Tac or the 3-in-1. Okay, so we're going to get this layer down. And I'm going to try, make sure it's up the right direction so it matches your center panel. And then we'll just get that down. And that's kind of there. Okay, so that's what we've got so far. So then we're going to take a piece of ribbon or twine. In this instance, I have some ribbon. I have a lot of ribbon. And I just want to make just a knot. Okay, you can make a bow if that's what you like, but I'm just going to just basically make sure that it's not twisted and just make that little tie there, like so. Okay, and then I'll just trim off. I'll angle my ends with a better pair of scissors. Okay, and I'll just angle those roughly the same length. Okay, awesome. And then I want to secure that little side panel so that it stays down, like in this card. So when you open this card, that panel, you know, it's adhered quite firmly. And to do that, I am going to use some glue there. I find glue does hold well. So we're just going to use the Tombow. Oh, I might be out of ink. I might be out of. Okay, and we're just going to put, you know, not extravagantly, but just enough down that will seal. Okay, we'll just press that down, and we'll leave that. We won't try to keep opening it. Okay, there's a good press there. All right. So then for our front panel, you can use any sentiment or mat that you want. I have a die cut that allows me to make this little scalloped edge, and I think that's kind of pretty. And then I do have another die cut for the center. And then I just stamped on my sentiment, happy birthday. You can put any sentiment that you want. If you have Christmas paper, you can make this a Christmas card. You can do whatever you like with it. Just looking around for my dimensionals. So for the top bit, the sentiment part, I'm just going to adhere that straight onto the mat. Trying to get it straight there. Okay, and then I want that just to pop a little bit. So I'm going to use some dimensionals, which are it's basically just foam tape. So if you have a roll of foam tape, you can just cut a couple pieces, or if you do have some dimensionals already cut, then you can just use those. And then we'll just get the back off. And then you want to try and center it as best that you can. With something like this, it's a little bit easier because I can count 1, 2, 3, 4 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's basically centering it by the orange parts, and just a little bit this way. So we'll get that down. That looks pretty good. So we'll press that down, and that just gives it a little bit of dimension. And then I cut out, again, from a die cut, some little flowers. You can cut these by hand or use any other kind of die cut that you have. I do have a little quickie pen, which is a glue pen. I have a bit of arthritis, so sometimes it's hard to deal with the little shapes. But this little quickie pen is a great little glue pen. It just need to make sure it's coming out. There we go. If you just had some regular glue, you could just dot a bit of glue there. Not sure how much glue is coming down with that, but I'll pop her on. So there's one of the little hearts, or the hearts, one of the little flowers. And then here's our second one. Yeah, the glue's coming out good there now. It's a good little glue stick, that one. Oh, and I smeared it all over my glass mat. We'll put a bit more. Okay, so then we'll get that down. And then for the center, I just have these little gold rivets. I think I picked these up at the dollar store. So we'll just stick one of those in for the center just to kind of make it pop a little bit. Okay, and then for these ones, we can just put them around your card. If they were in a contrasting color, we could put them on top of the card. And you could put, you know, another kind of flower there. I don't think those really stand out. So let's try a different color. I have a couple more cut here. So let's see. Let's see. I mean, on the camera, it's not, it's kind of blending in with the background, but in real life, although let's try, let's see about a different color. So I had cut out a bunch of these. So what about green? No. What about blue? Blue could go. What about yellow? No, I think I'll just stick with the red ones. And then I'll just put them kind of just around the card at random. And again, you can pop those up on dimensionals. So here I have this one, and I can just cut a piece off. You could put leaves behind it, which would make it stand out more. And or you could do a different motif if you wanted to do butterflies or you know, balloons or hearts. You know, put an extra heart there. So I think that stands out better when we put a dimensional on it. Okay, so that's the outside. And then for the inside, I made a little mat. Okay, and I just used a stamp set. So just inked that up, pressed it down, found had another little stamp. That came from the stamp set, but I think this is, it's Stampin' Up, but I think it's retired now. But I just used the little buds and a little flower. But you could use whatever that you have. And we don't need to really weld this down. It's just going to be used for a writing space. Oops, I got touched down before I was ready. So again, we just want to try to find out what our border is. Let's bring that a little closer and try and get that relatively straight. Okay. And then I just, with my envelope, I will just, I want to stamp a little flower on that. So I always have just a piece of scrap paper that I stamp off on just to make sure that the stamp is inking up properly. So it's pretty good. So I want to put it kind of at the same angle as I've got in the picture or in the card. So we'll just do something like that. Get that down. I'm just using some Ranger Black, Jet Black Archival Ink. And to clean my stamp, I just have under my desk here, I have some wet wipes. So we'll just clean that off, set that aside. Okay, wipe the glue back. Cap back on the glue. All right, so there's our first card for today. Very easy, and yet it's so classic. I mean, I think this is, you know, I was going to do a series called From the Archives, because this is like old as the hills. But it's just a lovely, simple card. So thanks for joining me today. If you did like this, give me a thumbs up. And welcome, you know, back to those who keep coming back and any new subscribers. I appreciate it so much. Leave me a comment and we'll see you next week.